I'm really excited that you're going to be part of the soiree because I think that women's empowerment is so essential to sex being safe. Mm-hmm. And I wondered if you could talk a little bit about why you teach S Factor and why you're offering at Foreplay.
Yeah, I'd love to. So what I do with S Factor classes is I really invite and encourage women into a place where they can explore and connect with their sensuality and their sexuality for themselves. Oftentimes when we think about sexuality, we feel like it's so that we can connect with another person and it's about actually having sex. And that's great because it actually might enhance that part of your life. And it really is an opportunity for women to connect with themselves for themselves. Mm-hmm. I joke around sometimes about how our sexual energy is like nature's greatest untapped resource. And to be able to have contact with that and connection with that really fuels us in our life all the time.
I think that sex is the most potent motivator on the planet. And for me, I know that sex didn't feel safe for a long time, and I feel excited about this event because I think that's really what it's all about.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I feel excited about bringing what happens behind closed doors, so to speak, mm-hmm. in the studio out into the public realm so that everyone, men and women, get to have an opportunity of one, being witnessed in their movement, but also getting to see women fully embodied in their erotic, sensual nature.
And this is a real edge for you because you teach women, so this is not only women and men together, but it's also a place where you're really helping people feel safe in a public environment.
It's true. I feel like there's so much work that we can do behind closed doors, but ultimately, if we're using this as an opportunity for growth and for personal development, that it needs to expand beyond what happens within the studio. And I'm excited to be wanting to move in that direction. And I have some dancers that are going to be performing with me, and it's their first time really being witnessed and performing ever, really. So it's exciting.
So I know you're also doing lap dance, mm-hmm. and I wonder if you could talk a little bit about
that. One of the things that I do in my S Factor classes is I very intentionally bring music and cues into my teaching to help women connect with their emotionality. A lot of what we do when we talk about erotic is actually like emotional. Our erotic body is our emotional body. And our emotional body might have its own expression that's very different than how we come from our minds. So,
I know mine is.
Right? So having said that, there's a process of first connecting with that within ourselves. And then the next level is to be witnessed by somebody else. So the lap dance really is an opportunity for women to have a body and a focal point to be witnessed in their emotional expression. Mm-hmm. So we give each other lap dance, women to women.
That sounds fun.
It's super fun.
Yeah.
And it's an opportunity to be able to have our full emotional expression through our body and be witnessed and supported by another person.
Aw.
Yeah, it's yummy. And it feels good. It's really yummy.
I imagine that if I did that, I had that practice and I felt safe and felt good at it, it could change a lot of how I felt about myself as an erotic creature or sexual creature and how I interact with my lover.
I have women send me emails sometimes at 10 o'clock at night saying, that class was so amazing, I had the best sex with my partner that I've had in 3 months, thanks.
Yes.
So yeah, of course, when we're more connected with ourselves and we're comfortable in our sexuality, it absolutely can ripple out into our lives and our relationships.
So some of your dancers are going to be performing for the first time ever,
yes.
and that's pole dance.
Yes.
So what makes S Factor pole dance different than people's general like sort of idea about pole, and maybe not just physically but also symbolically?
Right. I feel like it's a reclamation. In a lot of ways, the pole is a symbol of like the ultimate patriarchal objectification of women and their sexuality. And for some women, it's really, they don't come to class because it's too much a symbol of that. Mm-hmm. And for me, I feel like it's an opportunity to reclaim our own sexuality within that realm mm-hmm. of pole dancing and lap dancing. And I teach striptease as well. And it's actually really empowering to have it be for us.
I love women, well, I'm sure men too, but people who pole dance, they seem like very strong to me. And that makes me feel happy when I see a woman. And I'm sure you would teach men too at the soiree, but a woman who feels confident and joyful in her body, like, it just seems like the most erotic thing.
Mm-hmm. I think it's the most erotic thing. Whatever your body's complete, authentic expression is what I think is most erotic.
Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you. Yeah.
Is there anything else you want us to know?
I teach classes at 4:18.
that come at us.